students, welcome to Jam's tutorial. Today we have come up with a new concept related to classification of animals based on the habitat. So previously we have done a video based on classification of animals, but it was related to food habits. So my previous video was classification of animals based on the food habits, but today we are going to make a video on classification of animals based on the habitat. So habitat is nothing but based on the living region or living place. So based on the place where the animals are going to live, on that we are going to classify the animals. So if you are new to my channel, please don't forget to subscribe my channel to watch more upcoming videos. Now let us enter into our topic. So here we are going to classify the animals into totally five categories. So first one is called as the terrestrial animals. Okay, first classification is terrestrial animals, and the second classification is aquatic animals, whereas the third one is aerial animals, fourth one is arboreal animals, and the fifth one is amphibians. So I am going to explain you regarding each and every classification in detail. Now let us discuss about our first category, that is terrestrial animals. So here we are going to see what is meant by a terrestrial animal. So terrestrial habitats are the ones that are found on land. So here you can say that terrestrial animals are also called as land animals because they live on land, or they are found on the land. And on the land you have many kinds of places like forests, grasslands, deserts, coal regions, etc. So you can find different kinds of places on the land. For example, you can find the forest, you can find the grassland, you can find coal regions, you can find the deserts. So there are many places on the land. So all the animals which are living in the different places on the land are referred to as terrestrial animals or land animals. Okay, now most of these animals have legs. So most of the animals which are found on the land have the legs which help them to run fast. So whatever the legs those animals are having, they are helping the animals to run fast in order to catch their prey. So prey is nothing but the food they try to take in. Okay, the food they take in is called as the prey. So whatever the food they require, for example, if you take a lion, okay, lion has four legs. Now it is going to run fast with the help of its legs in order to catch a deer. Now this deer is becoming a prey for lion. So prey is nothing but the food of this lion. We call it as a prey. So in order to catch their prey, the animals are going to run fast with the help of their legs, or to protect themselves from becoming prey of other animals. So this is just the reverse of the above statement. So here you can see the same deer is there. This is also a terrestrial animal or a land animal, we can say. It also consists of legs which helps the deer to run fast in order not to become a food for the lion. Okay, so in order to protect itself from the other animals, so from the lion it has to protect itself, so it is also trying to run faster. So in this way the legs are going to help the terrestrial animals in order to catch their prey and in order to protect themselves from becoming prey for the other animals. Now let us see some examples of terrestrial animals or the land animals. So we have many kinds of animals living on the land. For example, you can take lion, tiger, horse, cow, buffalo. Okay, so you can also take a leopard, etc. So many of these animals have the legs which help them to run faster, I can say. So lion, tiger, buffalo, leopard, etc. are some of the examples of the terrestrial animals. You can take still more examples for. Now, our second category is related to aquatic animals. Now, let us see what are aquatic animals. So, aquatic animals pertain means nothing but refer to animals that live in different water forms. So, you have different water bodies present on the earth. So, more specifically here you can say aquatic animals are nothing but the water animals because they live in different water forms or water sources. So, what are the different water bodies which are present on the earth, like seas, oceans, rivers, lakes, ponds, etc. So, these are the different kinds of water bodies which are present on the earth. And the animals which are going to live in seas or oceans or rivers or lakes or ponds, etc. are called as aquatic animals or water animals, you can say. Okay, now here comes the question that how do they breathe? So here you can see these animals breathe air and they extract the oxygen dissolved in the water through organs called the gills. So they are living in the water. So even in the water, under the sea or under the ocean also, oxygen is present. So this oxygen is dissolved in the water. You cannot see it. You can just feel it by breathing. So oxygen is present in the water and they try to breathe that oxygen with the help of a special organ present for them called as gills. And these gills are present in their skin. So with the help of the gills, they are going to take in the oxygen and release the carbon dioxide. Now let us see some of the examples for the aquatic animals. So here I am going to write some examples of the aquatic animals, such as you can take whale, shark, crab, turtle, seahorse, okay, tortoise, crocodile, okay, walrus, so you have etc. You have many examples of animals which live in the water. So you can write still more examples for the aquatic animals. I would like to discuss one more point regarding the aquatic animals here. So, as I said you, they try to breathe with the help of gills. But still, there are some aquatic animals which does not consist of the gills. So, gills are present specially for the fishes. So, they try to breathe with the help of the gills. Whereas some aquatic animals which does not have the gills try to breathe in with the help of their skin. So this is one more point what I would like to discuss. Our third category is aerial animals. Let us see what are aerial animals. So aerial animals are considered as those which have the ability to fly. So which are able to fly are called as aerial animals. So flying movement is present in these animals, you can say. And they move through the atmosphere by their own means. They does not require any support. They try to fly in the air. Such kind of animals are called as aerial animals. And the forelimbs are modified as the wings to fly. They consist of wings, okay, or the feathers to fly in the air. And they also have feathers that keep them warm and help them during their flight. So what is the purpose of the feathers for them? It helps them to fly in the air, as well as it will also keep them warm, the body of them to keep warm and help them during their flight. Now here, I can take the examples here as some birds and insects, bats. These will be the examples of aerial animals. So there are many kinds of birds here, okay? So you can take the examples of birds such as albatross, parrot, vulture, crow. So these are examples of some of the birds you can take. Okay, and coming to the next category, insects, you can take the examples such as butterfly, bees, housefly, cockroaches, grasshoppers, etc. So these also have wings which help them to fly in the air by their own means. And bats also, you know, which try to fly in the air in the night time. So these are some of the examples of the aerial animals. Our next category is arboreal animals. Now let us see what are they related to. Now these are the animals who spend majority of their lives in the trees. So here you can see these animals try to live mostly on the trees. Such kind of animals are referred to as arboreal animals. And these animals have strong arms and legs to climb up and down the branches. So when they are climbing on the trees, up and down of the trees, they try to climb with the help of their strong arms and legs. It helps them to climb the trees or the branches. And they try to eat, sleep and play in the tree canopy. So most of the time they try to spend on the trees itself. They try to eat on the trees, they try to sleep on the trees and they try to play on the trees also. So here let us take few examples for this. So here I am going to write the examples for them, such as you can take monkeys as an example. Okay, you can take columbar as an example, which will be black in color. Okay, you can take squirrel as the example, which try to live mostly on the trees. And green tree pythons or snakes you can take, which tries to live mostly on the trees. Okay, and some kinds of lizards, especially chameleon lizard. Okay, so etc. I'm going to write, which are some of the examples of the arboreal animals. And our last category is related to amphibians. Let us see what are amphibians. Amphibians are the animals that live on land and in water. So amphibians try to live mostly on land as well as water. Such kind of animals are referred to as amphibians. They live on both land as well as the water. Only land animals are called as terrestrial animals and only water animals are called as aquatic animals. And the animals which live on both land as well as water are called as amphibians. Now here they reproduce eggs. They try to reproduce by laying eggs in the water. So reproduction is possible by them by laying the eggs in the water, and those babies are called as larvae or tadpole. Okay, after hatching of the eggs, whatever the babies that comes out from the eggs, we call them as larvae or tadpole. And these amphibians need water or a moist environment to survive. So where the amphibians are going to live, they survive in a place where they have water or they require a moist environment, means where the moisture is present, lot amount of moisture is present in the environment, there they can survive. Or if the water is available, then also they are able to survive. And they try to breathe with the help of their skin. So when they go into the water, so they try to breathe with the help of their skin. Okay, these are the animals which are related to amphibians. Now I am going to write the examples for the amphibians, such as frogs and toads you can take as the examples mostly for the amphibians, because they try to live on land as well as water. Okay, now these are the five different classifications of the animals based on the habitats. Hope you all like this video. Then please don't forget to like, share and subscribe my channel to watch more upcoming videos. Thank you for watching.